I started studying Chinese at Ohio University during my freshman year, and I caught the bug, you know. I have a very strong musical background, so the tonal qualities of Mandarin really make sense to me, and then the culture and the people and everything else about China that's so intriguing to everybody who studies the language really just helped me just develop that passion. I refused after graduating from Scripps to take a job that didn't involve Mandarin, because that was my true passion, along with journalism. But you have to find, I've found, in addition to writing or to broadcast journalism or online journalism or whatever, something else that makes you special. So that was Mandarin, and I refused to settle until I found something. So I applied online. I applied to Voice of America, I think, what was it, monster.com or something. And they called me a couple days later, if not the next morning. And I, a few months later, took a research position. And they asked me, as soon as I started, if I wanted to be on television. I had no idea I could do this. I studied abroad in China for most of 2007. I lived in Beijing and Hangzhou, which is just south of Shanghai, connected by a bullet train. And I studied language. I interned at an English language magazine and newspaper in Hangzhou, China. I wrote a weekly column about my adventures with learning Mandarin, all the mistakes you make and all the funny situations that come about when you pretty much fail at learning a language, or you forgot a word, or you left something out, and you end up completely on the other side of the city, or it's just these really funny situations that come up when you're studying abroad and trying to learn a language fluently. I wrote restaurant reviews, and I took pictures for the magazine and everything, so I got to really broaden my experience with journalism. I did really try to go back to China after graduating from Ohio University, but I feel like this opportunity not only sharpens my Chinese skills every week, because I broadcast, the language I use is Mandarin, but also I'm learning so much more about broadcast journalism. I'm writing, researching my weekly show. I'm hosting it in front of a camera outside in DC every Monday. And I come back and I cut it on Final Cut Pro. So from start to finish, your first job out of school is something that you can just do everything. Is something that I feel like I've found quite the gem, and I don't want to leave it yet. So as much as I really want to go back to China, I feel like I'm almost kind of have a better opportunity here in DC. My show is called Mei Guo Ren Zhe Me Shuo. It's What Americans Say. It's a weekly current events show for Voice of America China Branch, and we pick a current event. Last week we discussed the federal judge's decision to repeal or to strike down Proposition 8 in California. And we just ask Americans on the street what they think about these issues. And it's sort of, you know, in jaywalking, you know, on Jay Leno, but it's serious. And it's really cool because our Chinese audience gets to see Americans' opinions on these current events that not only Chinese people are interested in, but Americans can talk about at length. It's kind of hard picking that subject, you know, what can Americans really talk about, and what do the Chinese, what does our Chinese audience really want to know? So that's really fun. I get to introduce the topic and talk about it in Mandarin first, and then it cuts to a news package, and then we interview about 7 people. Every Monday. It existed, but I took it and I ran with it and made it a weekly thing. So it's kind of like my baby. It's what I do here now. It's my main thing. But also, I do a travel show for Voice of America. We produced the first few travel shows for Voice of America, the one in New York and the one in the South, talking about American culture and learning English while you travel. And we took those shows to Hong Kong, and they reviewed it with a college age focus group, and they loved it. They loved the English language learning aspect of the shows, and they also loved the food parts. We went to Savannah, Georgia, and I hung out with a chef down there. We made gumbo and everything like that. So I get feedback from these focus groups in Hong Kong that Voice of America sets up and pays for, and we understand what our audience expects out of programming. And so after they like those programs, I've been assigned to do a travel show a month. So we've done August and September, we're doing two DC local ones. And then from there, we're going to assess where we would like to go next. That didn't exist before I came. So it's really something that I've pursued. And because I've developed this passion for broadcast and for producing television, I think these opportunities have just developed. I've learned on the job how to be in front of a camera, how to memorize a script, and we don't have a teleprompter when we go outside, so that's quite the challenge. What I learned in PR and what I learned in J school, basically the writing skills, the core skills about how to tell a story from point A to point B, the inverse triangle, all the stuff they teach you when you first get there, and the info gathering and everything that you have to know really came in handy for switching from PR about, you know, promoting and everything to being a personality in front of the camera. It really was just throwing myself into it. I had no idea how to be in front of a camera, and I kind of had to call my friends and who were broadcast majors and say, how do I do this? What am I doing? There's one professor at Ohio University who really helped me understand the cold call, the cold approach to just approaching anybody or calling anybody on the street to discuss a topic or to set up a TV interview or anything. In PR, you learn that. You learn the cold call. You wanna call the journalist or whoever you're trying to get to come to your event or cover your event, and just do a cold pitch. And I think that in PR really helped me prepare for broadcast journalism, where I'm planning the interviews that we sometimes go out to interview specialists on our topics that we discuss for our monthly or our weekly show. Another thing that was really useful that had nothing to do with PR was radio. I did a radio show for WOUB, and that just really helped me understand what I sound like. Not what I look like or anything of that sort in front of the television, just honing in on what your voice sounds like. And if you have time, you know, in school, if you have time for an activity or something else that you want to pursue, I think radio is a really fun activity to pursue, because you can really develop what your voice sounds like, and it can help you get ready for a job that might involve speaking to large groups of people or being in front of a camera. If I could give one piece of advice to an incoming freshman, I would say learn a language. The world's only getting smaller, and organizations now are expecting you to wear many hats. You need to have that language skill. You need to have not only the writing skills, the core writing skills, which are crucial, but you also need to know, how do I do Final Cut Pro? How can I make a video that goes with this story? How can I take a picture that goes with this story? How can I be the one-man band? And that's one thing I regret not pursuing when I was there. I did the writing and I did everything else, but I didn't do very much multimedia, online journalism, things like that, because that's where it's heading. That aside, I couldn't stress enough how important it is to learn a language, and I'm biased. Go learn Chinese, because it's crucial. It's just, you need to know at least Spanish or Chinese or something involving the BRIC countries. Viewer feedback is interesting because Voice of America is blocked in China. They block YouTube, they block anything that they see with the Voice of America logo. That's mainland China. Taiwan and Hong Kong, we can understand who's watching and things like that, which television stations are broadcasting the television shows that we produce and such. But mainland China, it's difficult, because if you have a satellite or a certain sort of radio, you can listen or watch our programming. But they they tend to block most of the things that we send over to the mainland.